the Admiralty building in the background there with the green topped domes. To the right is the Museum of the Household Cavalry with the clock tower above, showing that it's just coming up to 9 a.m. You can just see the Shard top right, just behind the clock tower of the museum, is the tallest, the top of the tallest building in Europe, the Shard. And the referees being introduced, Marc Berard from France is the first referee, assisted by Damien Searle from Great Britain. Now, time to introduce the players. Marta Menegatti will celebrate her 22nd birthday the week after next. Here's her partner, Greta Ciccolari. And now the Russians. Katerina Konyakova comes onto court. Evgenia Ukolova is her partner. One of two Russian teams in the 24 who have made it through to the Olympic Games. So the Horse Guards Parade dancing troop make their way off. The officials have cleared the lines, or just finishing clearing the lines, and we're ready for play. Best of three sets, first to 21 in the first two. If we go to a third, it's a shortened set to 15. Day two, perfect conditions. Here we go. Starting right on time with the Household Cavalry Museum clock chiming nine as the first serve was struck. Okolova to serve for Russia. Menegatti trying to find a way over the top. This looks good for Russia. Menegatti, good defense. And she's read it well. Back on her feet now. Looking for some space. What a way to start. Yes! Menegatti tries again, this time it's too hot to handle. Persistent play from the Russian pair. Eventually they found a way through. Ukolova to serve again. 2-0 opening set. Well left. Greta Ciccolari had a great view of that ball and gave the lead call. Ciccolari will now serve. All four players are around 5 for 11. So no real height advantage. Good block. They kept the point alive. Can they finish it off over the top? And onto the sand. The Italians draw level. In fact, the Russian blocker hit the net quite hard, so that would have been a point even if the ball had dropped out. Ball has hit the net this time. That's okay, as long as the body doesn't touch the net. That was in. Pinpoint accuracy on the spike. The set was good. Komyakova's finish was perfect. Komyakova serving. Well left. Menegatti came very close to making the pass in the end. At the last split second, she let it go. Good judgment. 3 points all, first set. Menegatti to serve.
Yes!
Good judgment again. For the first time, the Italians are in front. So they change ends now. The Russians now move to the Downing Street end of the court. The Italians take up residence at the Mall end. And they'll change sides every 7 points, every five in the final set. So Marta Menegatti to serve. Checking the signals with Ciccolari at the net. She signals behind her back. Here we go. Menegatti's serve is short. It's picked up by the Russians. They look strong here. Plenty of space. And they find some. Komiakova serving. 4 points all. At the top of the net, the Italians have recovered their positional lead. That's going out. And they're back in front, Menegatti and Ciccolari. Ciccolari to serve. 5-4 the lead. That's a waste. Surrendering the one-point advantage with a foul serve. A few early nerves. It's the first match of the Olympics for both pairs. Okolova serving. Ciccolari set off the forearms. Menegatti dinks it over the top. And beats the defence. Perfect finish here, rolling the ball off the knuckles. Menegatti serving. Was going to go left and then right. She's decided now to go down the centre. And the Italians take two in a row to give themselves a two-point cushion in the first set. First set, Menegatti. This looks better for the Russians. They're in great shape on the far side, but they've missed the sitter. And I wonder if this will be a good time for them to sit down and take a timeout. Too many options there for Komiakova. 8-5, Menegatti again. Oh, and Komiakova's missed the pass. This will have to cross. So time and space for Italy to conjure something here. Here's the set. Ciccolari drills it down. Nine, five, another change of end. Still no timeout called from the Russian pair. We will have a technical timeout after 21 points have been played. So Menegatti enjoying a really good run with ball in hand. She served six times. 9-5 the lead. The Russians desperately need this point. Might not come their way. Ciccolari, Menegatti. It'll go straight back to Italy's side on the Downing Street end of the court. Ciccolari, pick it up again. Nudging it forward, that's gone. Terrific pressure from the Italians. And now, I think it's a bit late actually, but now the timeout has been called by Russia. But they're 5 points adrift. Reaction shot there from Menegatti. Saw that the players were out of position and that the court was wide open. Well, lots of chat on the Italian side. Silence for the Russians at the moment. Komiakova and Okolova have nothing to say to each other. Komiakova, they there with the yellow shades. The Italian team have powered away to a very decent lead here. It's Menegatti again. Where's this going? It's going to come dangerously close to the Italian side of the net. The Russians are all over the place. They need a point here. And finally, they break the deadlock. Ciccolari's pass. Here's the set from Menegatti. Oh, that was a miss. 2 points in a row for the Russians will give them a little hope of getting involved, getting a foothold again in this opening set. The spike from Ciccolari fired straight into the middle of the net. Okolova serving. Here's the pass, the set from Menegatti again. This looks better. It's dinked down. And the block was simple in the end for Katerina Komyakova. She crouched down and rose half a metre above the sand to meet the attack. 8-10. From 5-10 to 8-10, and the Italians are in trouble now. This has got to pass. This should be a Russian point. They've got so much time and many options here, and indeed, they've narrowed the gap to one. 10-9. And the Italians have decided to calm things down and take the wind out of the Russian sails by calling a timeout. Great example there of the clawed hand used. Okolova to serve. The set looks pretty good here. Oh, but for the second time in a row, Ciccolari is struggling to clear the obstruction. Came forward with good speed, but the ball wasn't quite high enough for her when she took the spike. All square, 10 points all. Okolova to serve. Well left. So the Italians re-establish the advantage. Ahead by one, 11-10. And it's time for the technical timeout and for the Horse Guards Parade dancers to appear. Quarters full, just after
you guys are awesome.
10 minutes of play on day two. 2 points in a row for Italy, back in front, an ace from Ciccolari. Like in tennis, an ace is an unreturned serve in beach volleyball, even if it touches the opponent on the way through. That one will be left. So a bit of both there from Greta Ciccolari. Komiakova serving. 11-12. Ciccolari sends it over her head. Ooh, that was careless from Menegatti. Really had a strong swipe at the ball. In the end, there was way too much on the spike. ...12 points each. Nervous moments for the Italians, having been so far in front. They're back in front again now. Come back. Oh, unlucky. Menegatti in the right place, but slightly confused by the fact that the ball hit the net so hard on its way through. Good improvisation from the Russian pair. And real power in that spike. Menegatti could do nothing more than get a wrist in the way. Well left.
The screen there from the Italian team shows that ball was going long.
Well, this opening set still wide open. The Italians had a 5-point advantage at one stage. It's down to one now. Greta Ciccolari to serve. Well played. Down the line with the spike. Nobody there to pick it up. The Russians are level again. Komiakova serving. Menegatti down on her knees. Now she's back to her feet. Could she finish it off? That was covered. And should have been punished by the Russians. That was a golden opportunity to get themselves in front. Menegatti, 15-14, oh, nearly, but not quite a 3-point for the Russians. They'll take those all day long. Kolova, Ciccolari, Menegatti, Ciccolari makes one at last. A couple of misses in recent minutes from Greta Ciccolari. She really needed a boost of confidence to make this spike. Came in with speed. The takeoff was perfect and the delivery excellent. All square again, 16 points each. Komiakova had time to pick a spot and serves now. Menegatti in a strong position. That's going to be difficult for the Italians to recover. They needed the block to land. And now there's real danger as the Russians get in front by one. Scrambled ball stayed on the Russian side of the net. Can they build on this lead? Ciccolari set, that's a little too deep. The Russians come forward again. This should be their point. It is. And they're two in front. Bit of a collapse from the Italians here, having been so far in front in the early stages of the first set. 18-16. Komiakova again. Menegatti, that's better. Well, at one point it looks as if the Italians would race away with this first set win. The Russians regrouped. Menegatti, the 21-year-old, 1 point behind she and Ciccolari. The serve is picked up, the pass is not so great. Russians are out of position, but make something out of nothing. Delightful finish on the angle from Evgenia Ukolova. 19-17. Ukolova serves. Menegatti's underneath it, coming forward now, across the angle, misses the target, set point Russia. Ukolova, 20-17, set point, Menegatti. Ciccolari's fired it wide. Desperate measures really from the Italians there. They'll be kicking themselves. They need to refocus on set number two. They had an enviable lead of 5 points midway through the first. They've lost the first set. Second set coming up. ...21-17, the first set score in favour of Ukolova and Komiakova. Players back on court before the dancers have departed. Here we go, set number two. Marta Menegatti will get things underway. Komiakova changing direction cleverly. Komiakova's serve. Ciccolari lifts it up. It's gone straight back to the Italian side. They must be able to create something here. Indeed. Ciccolari looking more confident as she climbed above the net, which is at 2 meters 24 for the women, 2.43 for the men. Boomer, well played. Great reactions. A little flick from Ciccolari to win the point. And this was all the more spectacular, bearing in mind how quick that ball was travelling on the spike. 2-1, Menegatti again. Didn't work this time. They might get another opportunity. Well left. Ciccolari and Menegatti leading by 3 points to one. Another reaction shot from Menegatti. That's better from the Russians. They'll be determined not to go 5 points behind in this second set like they did in the first. Katerina Komjakova's turn to serve. Menegatti with the pass. Here's the set from Ciccolari. Menegatti comes striding up the court and creates a beautiful rolled shot to the back corner. It's just about the best combination we've seen from the Italians. The set was perfect and the finish matched it. 4-2. Menegatti watched that one, had it covered. Can she finish again? Oh, block is good. Five to the lead. As they change sides, the Russians take up position at the Downing Street end now. Five, two. Menegatti serving. Menegatti down on her knees, trying to crawl across the sand to make the pickup. The finish from Komjakova was perfect. Kolova serving. Ciccolari lifts it up for Menegatti with speed again, but too much pace on the spike. Russians are closing the gap. Four, five. Great block. Komjakova watched the ball intently and rose to meet it with perfect timing. Five, five. Lots of discussion between the players. The Italians communicating all throughout the game. There's lots of noise from them, less from the Russians. The Russians are starting to take control of this match. 21-17 in the first. System, the way it works, you've got to be pretty unlucky not to qualify for the knockout stages. Of the 24 teams who start the tournament, 16 go through to the next stage, so only 8 miss out. And from what I've seen so far, I'd be surprised if both of these teams weren't in the round of 16. Full stages are such that you can afford to lose a match and still come back and qualify. Komjakova, Ukolova, 7-6 up, well left. Just a little bit of breeze around. Beach volleyball is pretty light, about a third lighter than a football. So the wind can have an effect. I think the way that temperatures are rising around horse guards, people would be happy for a little breeze to cool things down.
Here we go, 7-0.
7-0. Menegatti. Over the top, Menegatti had it covered, but it's come straight back to the Russian side of the net as they recycle this ball and drill it down right onto the line. Perfect placement in front again. 8-7. Clapping. with Colliver's attempts to keep the ball as low as possible across the top of the net, let her down there. Greta Tricolari to serve. There's a point for the Russians. The first referee insists that the net or the antenna was touched. We'll try and see it again, figure out exactly what happened. The Italians are unhappy with the decision. Here we go, was it a net touch or did the... Yeah, net touch, the faintest touch from the left wrist of Ciccolari. And they've lost their composure following the row with the referee. Komiakova, 10-8. Menegatti, better looking set this time. Nothing that Komiakova could do about that. As it fizzed off her wrists. Slower ball. Russians come forward to meet it. Ball ricocheting quickly between the two Italian players. Good defensive work as well. Over the top. Oh, what a shame. Menegatti did all the hard work, but when it came to the subtle touch at the finish, her skills deserted her. Komiakova serving. Menegatti, it's a little too deep. Net touch against the Russians. I think a little unlucky. Kolova, I think it was skidded into the base of the net. And now they take their seats for the technical timeout after 21 points of the set have been played. The Italians in a good deal of trouble here. They led comfortably in the first set before losing out. They led again in the second set, but have been caught and overtaken. 10-11, second set. The Russians beginning to control the match and find the wide open spaces with great ease. Komiakova to serve, 12-10. Tricolari sets it up for Menegatti. Simple move for the Russians to take control of the rally. Nothing going for the Italians now. Komiakova again, 13-10. Surely this time the Italians have to get a point on the board, and they do. Well worked. Good exchange between the two Italian players, and the finish had no response from the Russians. Menegatti to serve. Checks the signal with Ciccolari. Menegatti. Good looking set. Good defence. Menegatti turns defence into attack now and beats the Russians on the block. The advantage down to one single point. Yeah, nothing they could do about that one. The Russians are back with a little bit of daylight at 14-12. Vakolova to serve, Evgenia Vakolova. Minagati's in a good position here. Oh, great pickup from Vakolova. Komiakova, Vakolova comes forward, easy pickings in the end. Timeout called by the Italians in a last-ditch attempt to slow the momentum of their opponents. Italians back on court, still believing that they could have some further input in this match. The Russians are way out in front now, leading by 1-0, just 6 points away from the win at 15-12 in the second. Vakolova's serve, pushed forward, a little scrappy from the Italians. But they've got the point. The Russians are saying there was no touch on the ball on the way through, and they look pretty convinced about it. They've been told to change ends, but on the way through,
now,
they're arguing with the referee. Now let's try and spot a Russian touch on this ball as it went through. Might have just caught a fingernail. The Russians must now forget about the problem they had before and focus on this next play. Komiakova and Ukalova's turn to call the timeout with their lead diminishing. Players back on court. 14-15. Ciccolari's turn to serve. Can she produce an ace just to liven things up? It's picked up, it's dealt with, and it's rolled over the top. Recycled ball for the Italians, they're level. Another chance, the Italians, oh, that's not a great looking set. Dinked over the top, and it's touched on the way through. The Russians once again feel that they've been robbed. Two in a row that they've been desperately appealing. The Italians are in front again, 16-15. Ciccolari. from Yarkova. That's a better move from the Russians to square the set at 16 points each. Komiakova to serve. Managati's pass, here's the set. Managati returns to find a way through. Beautiful defense from the Russians. It's rattling around close to the net. Can they finish it here? Yeah, well played. Thumped away for the winner. The Arkham is 17-16. Minagatti's pass is poor, but she's recovered position here. What a shot! That might just be the shot that keeps them in the match from Menegatti. Her initial pass wasn't great. Flew off her forearms, but the finish was perfect. 17-all. Russians in good shape here. Blocked, they'll have another go. Can they find a way through? It's not good enough. It's come back down to Ciccolari. He just had to flick it away for a winner. The Italians are now 1 point in front, 18-17, second set. All square. Anybody's set now. Vukolova serving. Menegatti watched it closely and let it fly. Gift of a point for the Italians. Ciccolari knows that she has to put this ball into play and make the Russians play it. Here we go. They're coming forward. Looks okay over the top. Blocked. They'll come again. Second attempt for the Russians. No way through. Menegatti underneath it. Menegatti coming forward. No, not this time. Russians at the third attempt. Wonderful pickup from Ciccolari. Ciccolari! Set point, Italy. Well, one of the longest rallies of the match to bring up set point. It's got the crowd going here at Horse Guards. 2018, Ciccolari, who controlled that last point, will serve at 2018. The Russians are out of position. This is coming back towards Ciccolari. Can Menegatti finish it? She's giving Ciccolari the option, which she takes. One set all. Great fight back from the Italians. The Russians are still arguing the point with the referees at the coin toss to decide who will serve in the final set. Thank you.
that screw.
Now back to the final set of the screen.
Players back on court. The Russians will receive. There are the statistics for the second set, but it all comes down to the shorter decider. First of 15. Who's going to get the first point? Russia in good shape, and it's theirs. Menegatti coming forward. Yes, that will do. Honours even in the early stages of the decider. Over the top. Change of direction, perfect dummy. And Kumyakova and Ukolova are back on level ground, having slightly lost their composure midway through that second set. 2-1. Now, that was a gift for the Italians.
Split in this
15,000
seater stadium.
2-2, second set. Oh, it's carried. Remarkable. The wind has picked up, making life a little more difficult for the players now. Oh, Menegatti really should have put that away. The Russians might punish her, and they do. They change ends every 5 points in the final set. The Italians move to the Downing Street end of the court. The Russians were gifted an unlikely second opportunity to finish the point. Ukolova to serve, 3-2. High, floated, too high, too far. I don't think they can blame the breeze, which just seemed to have subsided while the Russians played that serve. Three all. It's off the net. Wonderful play. Oh, it bounced off the net. Once off the top and once off the frame of the net. Kumyakova will serve 4-3 final set. Ciccolari. Menegatti returns. Ciccolari in good shape over the top. This will require a chase. It's gone straight back to the Italian side. They have to finish this one. And they do. Following an attempted block from Kumyakova. Points all, final set. Menegatti's serve dipping towards the Whitehall side of the court. What a lunge from Menegatti. Wasn't able to get back on her feet to finish off the point. Can she defend again? Too good. Ukolova, Menegatti, Ciccolari, Menegatti. The ball lingered on top of the net like it was stuck there with some glue. The Italians come away with the point and they change ends. points, one set all, 5 points all in this Pool F preliminary match. That was careless. 11 points played in the final set. Time for the technical timeout. The Italians with ball in hand. Ciccolari's turn to serve. Russian's not in great position here. That ball should have gone at the first attempt. There were spaces to exploit. They might pay the price, the Russians. They do. Hesitation. They had a chance to finish the point in one shot without using the allotted three. They decided to linger. The Italians have a two-point cushion. Ciccolari for the second time. Decent-looking serve. Russians having to run. Menegatti in exactly the right spot to pick that up. Now she comes in at speed. Great defence from the Russians. Menegatti blocks again, dinked over. Can the Russians turn this into a winning play? It's out. Italy are three ahead. The Russians have plodded off to their bench for a timeout. Their heads have dropped. On the right there with the yellow shades is Katerina Komyakova. She and Evgenia Okolova are saying nothing to each other again. Players back on court. The Italians in good shape. There's a medical timeout though for Katerina Komyakova. She's requested some attention to that right shoulder.
Did it feel unstable, like it was going to go out or something?
Okay, Mal, can you hear me, Mal Sand?
I don't know if she's had a problem in the past with shoulder dislocation. But the medical guys and the translator communicating with her, asking if she's had a problem and that she felt it was going to go out. Was that a sign of a possible shoulder dislocation? I mean, I had one of those myself in April. I wouldn't wish it on anyone. Italians staying warm, keeping themselves moving around the sand during the medical timeout here. There's the scoreline, 21-18 in the second set for Ciccolari and Menegatti. And Here they are serving, or about to serve, at 8-5. Halfway towards their required total, more than halfway, with a shortened third set play to 15. So a nod from Katerina Komjakova. She's happy to continue. Coming out into this cauldron of an atmosphere now with the London wave rippling around Horse Guards. Going towards Downing Street and then all the way down to the mall end of the stadium, back towards Whitehall. 8-5, final set. Chikolari. It's a perfect restart for the Italians. No breeze to speak of, but the ball dipped viciously down to the sand as it cleared the net. 9-5, they're four in front. Chikolari again. Another good serve. Two in a row, two aces in a row from Chikolari. And they're 5 points clear. Now remember, they were 5 points clear in the first before they squandered that lead. Surely, lightning won't strike twice for the Italians here. 10-5 up, five away from victory over the Russians. Chikolari, it's come off the top of the net. The Russians with a chance to come forward and find some space. Good finish. Great pickup. The ball was lifted to the perfect spiking position. The Russians follow up that good move with a foul serve. 11-6. Marta Menegatti, just 21 years of age, takes her turn to serve at 11-6. It's off the net. It's another ace. Well, since the medical timeout, it's been all about Italy.
It's now 12-6. Has a 6-point lead here in the deciding set.
Menegatti again. 12-6. Better positional play here for Russia. And they close the gap. Is it too little too late? The Italians receiving now will fancy their chances of getting within striking distance of victory here. Evgenia Ukolova to serve. 7-12. Menegatti. Menegatti returns to try and finish the point and does so in some style. Sending that ball speeding down towards the sand like an arrow. 2 points from victory. Russian head staring down at the dirt. Against Spain. 13-7. Greta Chikolari serve. Menegatti got a fist to the ball, but couldn't lift it up. 7-13. The Italians with a great opportunity about to receive. Komjakova's serve. Chikolari. Menegatti coming forward. They've got a point. Net touch against the Russians. Match point, Italy. Crowds around Horse Guards parade stand at match point. That's out, and the Italians have fought their way back. They were able to banish the memory of the disappointing first set when they were 5 points clear before squandering that lead. They fought bravely in the second and took advantage of a real momentum swing in the third and final set to take their first full match. The Russians are continuing to argue with the referee, and it's getting a little heated, and slightly ugly out there now as the Russian player gets in the way and prevents the referee making progress towards the bench. And she's continuing to argue with the officials on the bench, on the court. The Russians feel as if they've been robbed of a couple of points. If they were, it involved a fingernail or two, nothing more. Italy have the win. 17-21, 21-18, 15-8. Service errors in the end from Mikolova and Komyakova. That made a significant contribution to their defeat. Just under an hour this match lasted. So I look back at some of the highlights of this tight match. In the end, a defeat for the Russians, but they're, despite their complaints, they're not out of the competition. The pool round-robin system allows them to lose a first match and still compete for medals. The Italians thrilled with the way it worked out for them.